Aiden? Aiden! I've got Frank here. At least what's left of him.
Aiden, where are you?
The 30th floor. The infected. They blew up.
Fuck it. I told you.
Frank? Wait! Where are you going?
He's as good as dead, Luan. I'm sorry. This is where I lost all my night runners. I'm not going through that again.
He's not dead yet. He's there, and he needs you.
He needs a cop. That's what he needs.
Frank, you smelly old alcoholic cunt. Why don't you fucking get a grip on yourself and step up for once?
Aiden, some of our equipment should still be there. In the elevator shaft. One or two floors above you.
Yeah, Frank, I think I found it. What's it for?
It's a grappling hook. A rope launcher.
So what?
We'll help you climb. Aim it at something it can attach to, and shoot. Try to use it to get onto the terrace. Let me know once you've done it.
Okay. I'm on a terrace.
Cool. You see my canteen?
Yeah, you bet. Looks really tiny from here.
Cool. Now open your paraglider, jump, and fly to the fisheye. See you there.
What?
Time to end this madness, Aiden. You have a paraglider. Get out of there while you still can.
Frank, I need to go up. You said you'd help me.
Better trained men than you have died there, Aiden. I won't lead you to your death.
Frank, I'm going up. With or without you. Are you too drunk to realize that?
Luan told me about your sister. She must be dead by now. But you're alive. And if you come down, you'll stay alive.
Fuck you, Frank. We're done here. I'm going up. Better. What's next?
Good. Now throw the switch, and that's it.
It worked.
Great. And listen, been thinking. Radio New Hope is still an option, but it's your choice.
Juan gets what he wants and gives me what I want. The way to find Mia. The truth about her.
Sometimes our choices are bigger than ourselves. Sometimes the things we do, they matter. I'm not gonna try to convince you. You got the transmitter working. It's your call.
Frank, what kind of music did you used to listen to?
What?
I'm wondering what kind of music you'd play on your radio station. And don't tell me it'll just be you talking all the time. If so, I'm changing my mind.
You motherfucker! I can't believe it! Thank you, Aiden. Thank you so, so much. You have no idea. Any kind of music. Anything you want.
Aiden, something's gone wrong. We can't detect the transmitter signal.
The people need this antenna more than you do.
What? Aiden? What have you done?
You'll hear soon enough. And let's hope Frank's still got it.
Frank, you handed control of this antenna to that washed-up drunk. I can't believe it. I'll take it back. I promise.
Yeah, good luck climbing the building yourself.
Aiden, and I thought we were becoming friends.
Sorry, Jack. I made my choice.
Good day, Philidor. Frank is back, and I've got some more exciting news for you. Blankets, food, and drinking water are being collected at the canteen. All those in need can report to Nicholas. Stay tuned, and I'll be back soon with another message of hope. Meanwhile, enjoy the music.
Don't fall asleep. Don't close your eyes.
You made it.
Hey, it's good to see you too.
Don't ever fucking do that again.
Hey, where did that come from?
You owe me one. So soles of my sneakers nearly tore off trying to get to you.
I'm sorry?
Sorry? I thought I'd be scraping your guts off the fucking pavement, and you're sorry?
Juan, I don't believe it. You were actually worried.
Shut up! Like I said, you owe me. My sneakers are ruined. I can literally feel the concrete scraping my feet. We need to get me a new pair.
Well, they don't look that bad to me. You sure we don't have more important stuff to do?
If it was their looks I was worried about, I would have trashed them ages ago. I risked a trickier route to get to your sorry ass faster, but the wind blew me into a broken banner. Fucking spikes were nastier than they looked. They were my last pair of intact shoes, Aiden, my soulmates in this dirty revenge-seeking business. Without them, I'm... Look. So, let's go.
You want to go shopping for new sneakers now? Is this some kind of joke, or...
Do I look like I'm joking?
Luan, you said... Hey, it's good to see you too.
Don't ever fucking do that again.
Hey, where did that come from?
You owe me one. Soles of my sneakers nearly tore off trying to get to you.
I'm sorry?
Sorry? I thought I'd be scraping your guts off the fucking pavement, and you're sorry?
Juan, I don't believe it. You were actually worried.
Shut up! Like I said, you owe me. My sneakers are ruined. I can literally feel the concrete scraping my feet. We need to get me a new pair.
You want to go shopping for new sneakers now? Is this some kind of joke, or...
Do I look like I'm joking?
Shit. Luan, it's not a sign of weakness to say you were worried. Can you at least tell me where we're going? Aren't a lot of shoe stores open in the area, I bet.
There's a place. Some of my old stuff might still be there.
I thought all your stuff was at the Fisheye. But I guess that's not where we're going.
Just shut up and follow me. Good opening? Apartment 216. Go look for a large red box with gold trim. That's where I stored my shoes.
Aren't you coming with me?
You're why my shoes are ruined. You get me new ones. Go inside, take the shoes, and leave. And don't touch anything else. Got it?
Hey, look, you got me suspicious, Luan. What's going on?
Just go get him, would you? You climbed the fucking TV station tower. You can climb into an apartment.
It depends on what's in there. I'm fine, chicken. Pretty cozy nest. You shared it with someone. Do you still live here, or...?
Nobody lives there. Just find the fucking shoes and stop asking dumb questions.
Why'd you ditch it for that den at the Fisheye?
'Cause that den is my home. I took all I needed with me. Except for the shoes, that is.
Hey, Luan, I found your shoes.
Great. Now get the fuck out of there.
Aww. But it's quite the love nest, with the wine and the view and the music. I mean, I'm starting to see a whole new Luan here. And you know what? I don't blame this guy, whoever he was, for liking her.
Fuck you, Aiden.
I didn't... Luan, wait. What? Come on. Oh, you bastard. Love alters not with his brief hours and weeks, but bears it out, even to the edge of doom. Shit, Luan! Here, I got your sneakers. You should also have this. I didn't realize you and Hakon had been together.
Why do you think he's so high on my hit list?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Just because someone reads poetry doesn't mean they don't deserve to die.
Did you guys break up because he abandoned Frank, or did he abandon Frank because you broke up?
There's really no point in analyzing that now, Aiden. Whatever happened, it was a mistake, okay? I should have never been so naive. That's why I didn't want you snooping around. For fuck's sake, you could have just respected that.
I'm sorry.
Forget we went there. Just leave me alone.
Luan, what's going on?
You just don't give up, do you?
You should know that by now.
You should know I fucking hate whimpering.
Saying how you feel isn't whimpering.
Fine. Stick around if you have to. But don't interrupt me. I'm busy.
Getting drunk?
No, you dork. Looking at the stars.
Hey, I can see the Big Dipper.
Aren't you brilliant? Except that's not the Big Dipper.
Oh, whoops. It was worth a try, though. You know any other constellations?
Yeah. Frank taught me a lot about the night sky back in the day. We were building the fisheye, and I'd climb the scaffolding all the way up to the roof. Frank would come up to tell me it's too cold, too late, and whatnot. But he always ended up telling stories for hours and hours. And I love to listen. The stars are so clear and seem close enough. You could grab them by the balls. Frank's way of putting it. Nice, huh? What about you, Aiden?
And what about me?
Do pilgrims get their hearts broken?
We tend to just forget it.
Wow. The shy type. Looks like your constellation is Cygnus.
Whatness?
There. Look. The swan. When I stargaze, I always find the swan first.
You're making all this up to impress me.
Maybe. Maybe not. Are you impressed?
Pretty much. And that poem?
It's just words, Aiden.
Words mean things.
Love's not time's fool. Though rosy lips and cheeks within his bending sickle's compass come, love alters not with his brief hours and weeks.
Just words, huh?
Yeah. Just words.
So, did you meet Hakon when you were building the fisheye with Frank?
He and Frank used to hang out with each other a lot. They were friends. It's a simple story, really. I was a young girl looking for attention. He didn't mind having his fun. The good thing is, lesson learned. For life.
You still care, don't you? Otherwise, why make me go into the apartment?
Yeah, I care, Aiden. About the person I am now. That's why I didn't want to go back there. So the weak little girl that lived there doesn't get the better of me anymore. I used to hate her. Now, I'm so over her.
Let's get some sleep.
Aiden? If I see Hakon, I'm gonna kill him. Simple as that. Don't try to stop me.
It's fine. but you know revenge doesn't make you feel better.
This isn't for me. It's for Frank. I will avenge everyone who died that night. A lot of stars winked out forever. Hakon talks big, but when it came down to it, he bailed on his friends and they died. He showed his real face. Fucking coward.
You can't turn back the clock.
True. But I can stop his fucking clock. And I fucking will. Now, good night, Aiden.
Luan, you there?
Right, folks. Let's start this new chapter with some inspirational music for you.
Aiden, you there? Come to the canteen.
No offense, Frank, but I really don't have any more time for you. Matt was gonna help me find my sister, but I gave the tower to you instead, and now I'm fucked.
Calm down. Come to the fisheye and we'll talk. I might have an idea. I wanna help you, Aiden.
Fine. Be there soon.